Nigeria, and we did discuss many issues today when we get to do with different parts of the world. Of course, not forget, say, yes, on Monday, we did day here, it's 9 o'clock to 10 o'clock. Then today, again, Friday, we did 9 o'clock to 10 o'clock. Something happened for this country, yes, yesterday, when we say in the morning, so around FDN, we talk about Senate, how they take also, Senate to the federal government, you know, they take care of this coronavirus very well. And the way they say they handle that. And that same evening, they say some Chinese day, and the women say whether they test positive, small time they look them again, they discover, say they don't do negative. Then next day, we just see Lagos State Minister of Health don't already confirm one case of coronavirus. So now they think they don't come to Nigeria and they don't deal with us. So, of course, anywhere we do, so. Federal government will begin to bring out some measures. State government will begin to bring out some measures. Even local governments will bring out some measures. One of them, I be say, many people are not going to gather for the same place all the time. That is congregation. People are not going to congregate. Maybe people are not going to touch body for inside. But many things go happen. But as the events unfold, we'll discuss them. But number one, we'll talk about today. I deal with some seasoned security experts, private security experts in different areas. We'll see the day. And they want to share some light on the different kind of different security approaches when we do most of the insecurity for the country, and mostly from Edo State, when we say from the region. I deal with my brother, Bright Omovido. Bright, good evening, sir. You know, say, no, no, we're not. We're not. You know, anything don't start to. So I don't go be take your hand. That's it, just. That's what you mean, my brother. All right, Reverend Sharif, deal with us. Oga, good evening, sir. Then, Adib Wale, Adini, my brother, good evening. Yes, Sharif, make us start from you. If you look at Edo, for instance, where we've only reached the whole world, we don't hear different ways when this insecurity, different people talk, different things. First of all, as a security expert, or what do you I don't see concerning this, all these people, the case man, this one, that one, what do you I don't see, if I ask you?
My eyes don't see many things. Because security matter, let me matter when you play, let me matter when you politicize, let me matter when you put under the carpet, let me matter when you use black paint. Because security matter when you affect everybody. Whether you're a rich man, whether you're a poor man, whether you go to school, you don't go to school. Security matter, we affect everybody. It's security matter, you must have no get out. You don't get USB, you don't get ICC. If you go to your daughter, come and catch you. So when it comes to security matter, it's not a matter of, it's not a big deal. It's not for everybody. So everybody's involved. Is part of now. When you come to Benin City, for example, in those days, there's what we call but now, 7 o'clock, everybody won't come. Not because they like to enter house, but because of the situation on ground. Everybody's running from this issue of insecurity. And I want to say this moment that security is the safety of lives and property. And people think, say, security now for big men. Big men, you know, they happen to us. But now,
it's for everybody. So if you're not careful to be more security conscious, you become a victim to what is happening now. And coming to our state here, our state is very, very porous to insecurity. Everywhere is like we are besieged by invaders. Whether you believe it or not, whether you like it or not, we have been besieged by invaders. So it is time for everybody to be more security conscious, to be more security sensitized, so that we will join hands together, even with the security people, the police, and others, to make sure we fight this issue together to a standstill.
If I ask you, as you talk on my good, so to you now, when you see me, all of us join hands together, what do we want?
Really, one of those things, like what the government is trying to do concerning the community policing, I think is part of it. Because we discover that there's a gap between the police and the community. And now they're agitating for community policing. If you watch very well, Sir Robert Peel, two-time Prime Minister of UK, he was the one that introduced community policing. He established London Metropolitan Police. The purpose is that he discovered that there is a gap between the police and the community. So he tried to bridge the gap so that the police can become the community and the community can become the police. That was why he came up with this community police. And we discovered that there is a big gap between the security agencies and the people, that is, the citizens. If we're able to bridge this gap together, it's just like husband and wife matter. If the man knows the house, the woman is at home alone, that woman is not safe. If two of them come together, they can build the house very well. So if we cooperate together, the police people and the community people come together as one, we can fight one common enemy called insecurity.
Bryce Omovidoro.
It will be better for you.
You see, make I tell you some of my experience. Because my people for us, this one we talk now, we talk now from Edo State. Any part of the country when they watch us, when time we reach future three experience. You get one there, they travel from Edo State, and they go or but the journey not be one day journey. So when I reach after our Via River, if you watch, over some kind of when happen, many checkpoints did that route. So when me and some of my colleagues, they pass, when we reach the stop, when we reach, we will all stop, we will ask that question. At the point, they don't go on and begin to say, the reason of this are police dinner. If you get anything, maybe they give me. I know some of them say, no. See, because so many people, they hate the police, so if I come business, maybe they give them something now. If you go give them this, I can't leave now. So I can ask many questions. One of them, they say, when kidnapping or most of those things they take place with happen, he gets a group of people who say it always he has seen them for the police with the as from of the God, maybe the UPC. And let me bring you up today. Now they follow these policemen, they go because before now our papa won't be a mono or about to pay the same. It don't like poor woman team, but 3-4 months ago appear. When he come, I think all the niggas want to let's say some of foreigners don't invade in foreigners. I don't know whether when I hear that time, yeah. When Oba make that. So first of all, my upright, wait till I don't see for foreigners.
Apollo, thank you so much. Our people for house, this one not be the one now when person they say whether they don't come. As I'm talking to you, the insecurity in Edo is alarming. Because people will come from outside, come and settle in Edo, and would they do bad? This is the time when Edo people come together. All of us, when they this community, now we know every road when they the community. Outsider cannot come and be kidnapping our people. We sit down, fold our hands. Like when you give example just now, say from Via River go. I don't know whether our people still remember that time. If you know, at least every week, they would be kidnapped. Fulani herdsmen would misbehave there. Since we took over that place, Can you still hear anything now from Ovia River go reach Ohosu to say kidnapping day? So the people, when they come, they don't leave their head for house. But this is the high time when all of us, when be city youth for Edo, in every community, OPC is there. Let us come together. One of the ideologies of OPC is, as you, wherever you find yourself, you make the people sleep with their two eyes closed. Are you listening to me? What we want is this: if we are recognized, because the people that are coming, they are coming for two purposes, with one, two security in their mind. One, they have the barrel, the gun they can use to kill people. The other one, they have spiritual backing. And that is what we specialize in, because we believe if you acquire power and use it to perpetrate evil, you will not last. They don't leave their head for house. But what we just need is organization in Edo. We should be, you know, say Benin man, they talk and say, if they don't invite you go party, you break bottle, you go pay for it. And we've experienced cases when we still pick our people, pick those people when they do, our boys will pick them, we hand them over to police. In the next, they will say, come and write statement. And me and you know, say, to write statements, now to sit down after counter. So those this thing they draw us back.
I don't understand. Explain that thing well. Because not true. At least I'm a journalist. Now information, now we take the work. I say some of the men when I know, they say sometimes when there is kidnapping, when there is some of this crime, some of the people now go fully go inside the bush. And at the end of the day,
nothing to show for it.
They will feel rescue most of these people. So when you say sometimes what will be the issue when they get to them?
A lot of issues they want with the get with them. First of all, if it happened, now with the lead the now with the front, we are very good in where they call hell now home for us. That is why we are saying let us properly organized. This one when you talk, no, the issues when we they get, if I tell you what we are doing there, it's purely on humanitarian basis. They are not paying on my boys. But why we tell them to go, we must start from somewhere. Since they refuse to recognize and appreciate what we can do, we decide to start from that side. But today we are proud to see all those 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, in fact, where did the past come and are there with the hood? Make them come, whether they leave their head for out. But we want to be encouraged, and it has gone beyond a particular community now. Every community in Edo State, their youth should be mobilized, organized. So if those people come, they meet resistance, they will not come back again. Let me give you one instance. Can you go to Delta Bayelsa now? Can say you want to go there, go and perpetrate evil.
But that Delta, when you talk, now with the exception, because I remember say that road with the. If you go Abraka, you know how you go Abraka. If you know from Abraka, you won't go Adbo. You know that route where they pass go Gume. You dare not pass that route. In fact, now who carry head for us that they pass that route? Then too, the way mostly that area where I talk, the attacks when we say the people they get for them, the data people never really can't solve the problem. In a way, you understand? So when you, but if not by I for that part of, now that part of that I talk will not be the whole at least that I will, whom I see. What I want to talk now, your guard talk so. When you now follow, go bush, would it be some of the things when they see where they make people fear?
When people
they
fear?
Would it be some of the things when they see where they make people fear? When I say more than people, if you ask, which one receive, when I say, the public, no.
Many. My we are talking about here just now. My people ask, more than I hear me very well. You accuse one, you accuse them just now. Abi, you talk one word, you say, after you don't do finish, police go say, make you sit down, make you write statement.
What would be the meaning of that?
I want to, like me now, I'm the pure civil defense man.
Okay.
Even in my street, I'm the civil defense in my street, in my area. I handle 4 or 5. Street in my area.
Okay.
You understand? I remember one time ago, I be accident, did it do base. Good Samaritan Junction by Federal Road. Good Samaritan.
No need to mention
Federal Road. And I had to take it to base. Then, I did there some boys go rob for like 2 houses after the accident. Then, that waiting you talk just now, the one tell you now.
Yes, tell me, tell me.
So, when they rob them, smother the arm robber, they pass me. They come out, they wear this OPP cloth. After they pass finish, you know, reach 10 minutes, people from the place, they just had come, thief, 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 thief. Ah, now I say thief, for here, they say for back here, now they do thief. Ah, they go to the person here, he say we are blue OPP. Ah, now they call up my boys, I say, make una come. I say, right now, this boy never go far, no na find out. And this time was around 9. I said, in the evening, 9 after 9, I said, Una must bring this boy out. True, they fetch this boy out. When they call me around 12:30, we carry the boy. As they beat the boy, says the boy not talk, where he put it, the gun. Where will they get problem, and one of the night they tell you, so he not talk, where he put it, as they push one, they go run to where the gun. And if you hold that person at the station, government go, police go, as you say, wait till you see for him when you tell you say native. And you see this person with gun, but as it wrong, he go through one. Let me that place when my God they tell you just now. Then when you reach station, police will come tell you me and say, which you see for that man when you take all active. But that day when I reached there, and I say, as he just see me, he say, my God, what you see? I say, okay. I can't look at him. His father, they work for his father. Because I'm a plumber by profession. I didn't work for your father. Ah, how? Now I say, okay, where the gun when they say for your arm? He said, okay, I will tell you the truth. Look where that plant is, they will see the gun. I carry and get up, I say, me the follower. The follower, he bring the gun. But when we carry this boy to the station, now it's 3 days. They bring the boy. They say, make me and my boys now come and write statement.
Say you too.
We are money.
As we tell Lucy now, chief. So many things they happen.
No. So let me call up for there. See. Go ahead, finish.
So you see, all this time I'm finished. All this time they see about security.
You know they encourage you now. You know they encourage you now.
No, they encourage us. Okay. At all. Before me, they talk to me. I say, me now civil defense for 3 streets. Now December, I drop up. I mean, this January, on the 29th of January, now I drop up.
You drop up?
Yes.
Why you drop up?
One, they know they pay.
Two, who know they pay the street?
The street will not pay you.
No, but he get one time more. Some areas they engage street vigilante. If you be say this one where they do and where you don't do and. When I supposed to reach one time where you go tell and say, this one they do una they sleep. Me no they sleep. Una no go pay me. When I supposed to discuss and now.
Yeah, if the agreement will start, they'll follow you, make the agreement, you now start and say this is not security for this street and this street. Mm-hmm. They'll pay you the first money, second month. The other one, when they won't pay you, you will receive 1.5. Maybe you receive 15,000 or 20,000, they'll come give you 5,000. Before you collect 1 month money, 2 months don't pass. How would that kind of a person say he won't come to security? And this security, when many of us do so, you know what my God tells you, if you like, you carry biro. We know they fear that one. That one will be the problem.
They don't know barrel, say gun.
Eh? So they carry barrel, they carry gun. We don't get problem for that one. But even the street when you want guide, they go talk to police, say, make police agree, make you owe gun. Then another different thing for the person when you employ as a security. Mm-hmm. You know if you follow and go station, say, at least this is not the DPO of this station. Make you.
But now those people, they make the mistake, because ordinarily the way government also move to do one, if people want to engage you now,
yes,
engage any private security at all,
yes,
first of all they're supposed to carry them, go meet police.
Thank you.
Say Ogaluko, these are the people where we say go to guide our area, just in case may they work with you now. If you say the matter feel hard, where they can't even call now, you call police, get direct access to police.
My brother, there are many things I see documents, they rob for one street. The DPO call me, say that they rob.
DPO call you?
Yes.
In the night?
Yes.
Okay.
Moses Olariwaju called me, said they rob. Around 8. I go to the place, where they rob. I rush to the place. I meet them, don't come. Now I say, wait, they have said they start work 10. I say, as you call me, now take off. We talk, you have the same, we talk to the community, media. Make them change up to 8 o'clock because my area rugged finish. Then the person they call rob, so he documents After the boys don't work out, they go through with the documents for the street. When me, the pit when I did, I can't see this document for now. I just see the team paper menu. As TikTok, look at, I say, this is not this man that they call like this man. Document be this. I can't pack the document. The moment as I see the document, I call the DPO. I see this man document now for so place. He say me, I gather around. I call people from the street, say, see what happened. DPO say, make one of them for the street, follow me. Come. Then I street people now. You know what you're doing with them?
Yeah.
He say, that document not be from the street. He say, you know, they come out, you know, they go station, you know, they go station.
And you know why, of course, you know, see, that one, you know the way a country be. Now, the same fear one they get. But, that is if you, but you know, what is with the truck, eh? The matter, don't, let me also, Oga, you they should listen to all of them. I'm sure at a point you also make your own comment on this decision. But what do the chat up say? Those things don't already they on ground. Will they live with some? But will they say, we're not going to continue to live like that? Because the door of the police, they open. The door of the DPO, they open. Particularly when you join them. I tell you, say, security men, and they tell us, I meet some of them. So all these people won't they see. If they all this tick bush, now then they follow. Now then they follow us, and then they help us. Well, make us encourage. Now police they tell us all this also. So and yes, make us encourage. So we know if we just keep quiet, they look, because we don't know tomorrow. And the tomorrow when we talk, so now we did this. Our bad daughter, some men don't enter forest. We did that time. But what of our brothers and sisters? We did that forest.
Okay.
We there here for ITV News now. Now we try ITV News. All those are brothers for Odiri, Odiguatwe, Sasnumba. They don't feel they go farm again. I mean, not so. So we don't feel just they do television, talk for TV, come on.
That Odiguatwe, what people say they there.
Okay. So what if TV, which report they give them from that side?
No, which thing that they try to talk, they say, if the government or the policemen really want OPC to work, no community. When OPC not there for the other to buy.
Okay, what we not do the good thing? What we never feel every for that?
We did there, but now my Ogato can just now. You see, party when they for not invite you.
Okay.
If you break glass,
yeah.
You go pee.
Yeah.
Okay, like now you the shot, thief. Me come out now, I get going and I don't license her. I can't kill thief. Thief now no who gone. Who they go say, you know, agree against it, now you kiss it, now you
Oga, you be first one to say, you don't work this security thing. This issue, you hear what I tell you just now? As I said, they go, and they do my investigation, they go. Some policemen, officers, tell me, say, look, most of these guys, say, mostly inside the thick bush, when they get some challenges, now then, they follow them, they go, to do some rescue, to do, of course, you know, say, in off air, they fit tell all this kind of thing. But when they go reach headquarters, for instance, police no fit just say, na so so people, na he help us do this thing. They go only one take the group, but off air. That I remember that one street, one time ago like that, Amrobat entered the street. Somebody come bring out Ishakabula, fire. But police can advise and say, no, make the man not to say, na he do this. Make it also in the police. I should say all those on a security, this is just to protect the
over that man.
So, in this kind of action, what do you think we should do?
Security is everybody's business. It's not only for the police. And we should not leave the world for police. And I want to say, because like Nigerians, there's a way we're brought up that any security threat, everybody will be police. Any security threat, everybody look police. And we forgot that if you check the numbers of police in Nigeria, they are no more than 400,000.
They know it's around
something thousand.
Yesterday, the police did. When I come now, when IG send DIG, this in go House of Rep, they say they get 302
thousand
policemen.
Two hundred million people.
So that amount you call now, apart from the real amount you call, majority of them are guiding
VIPs, and also talk to, apart from those ones where it's up now, some, they call it other special protection, where they guide banks, embassy, high-class traditional rulers, members of House of Rep, and even ASUROC.
I think like that practice is done almost everywhere.
Okay.
But the problem there is that the police we have, the recruitment...
Oh, that's speak Pidgin English, okay?
The recruitment of police is not the fast, because the population is increasing. We have not less than... we have more than 200 million people in Nigeria with less than this amount of police.
Mm.
And the police, they don't be angels. They cannot be everywhere, every time. The police are very few. So we always look at them. Any problem, police. They are very, very few. So my advice in this program is that...
No, you never reach advice.
Okay, we never reach that side.
No, we'll go advice later.
Okay.
Make I share, you see the problem with my brother and I reach now. Make us, so I talk this in the morning. They come, you get time to talk. Well. Now this matter make us come. I'll give you one experience. I think on Monday, make us share. Within the week, whether on Sunday or so, Sunday or Mondays, somebody close to us, not called, see Amrobadi area. Now I can't say, okay, no problem. I can't call control room. Control room, call them, say police could call me. So after like, close about 8 minutes, 9, 8 times, let's just say 10, 12 minutes later, one police can call. As at that time, I can't even call the control room back. When I call them back, they say, man, don't worry, they'll call me. Around 13 minutes later, one police can call me. And I said, oh, God. He said, now police believe so. I said, eh. He said, okay, what will be the problem? And I said, I'm already run for Suzu, please. Can't give the address. You know, he said, you know, Ubowo, Wasota. You know, if you follow Joe, follow Joe for Wasota. Use Joe to enter Wasota. That area, I for the wrong. Now the police tell me, say, then they come from a catalog. So, as at this time, the guys have come out. I don't want to drill into all of that. I only just want to support what you are saying, that we really need to do more. Because for now, as a government, as a people, the policemen will not get no rich. I wish there some other people there around that period. They fit catch those boys. Okay. But how you want to make, you know we have a catalog, before police go from a catalog, can't go
down.
So was I just about you?
I mean, why police do go over here?
Now they are patrol to me that. That patrol to can go to one assignment for that. They go investigate on, they pursue person go that side. But they come back. So finish your own. What I'm trying to say, this my brother talk some things. What would be your own advice and how to go about it? Number one, you talk about say please don't know if that person. If they're not, you understand. They're two. You also talk about the way the communities would react.
I think like what they are doing, they are doing a great job.
Okay.
They are doing a good job. But I will also say there that they should do more on their relationship. They should strengthen their relationship with the police.
Okay.
That is what I would say. They should strengthen their relationship with their police. Every DPO, the door is open. Rapport with the DPO. Have a good connection with them. You know, sometimes things like that can fail, but notwithstanding, I believe their doors are open. Anytime you call them, say we are so person, they will respond. When you have personal relationship with them, because you are into security, you must not, security matter, there's no way you can put police outside. You cannot do security matter without the presence of police, because they are the custodian. And when they are able to rapport with the police, I believe to an extent, their work will be appreciated. Then secondly, sir, the numbers of police when we get for this country is too few to handle the security level we have gotten to. We are talking about 200 million persons. It's not a joke. And security matter not just Edo State. Security matter is not a localized matter. It's a globalized matter. Everywhere you go, even America, go to Europe, go to Asia, everybody has its own problem. Nigeria own. Is becoming something else. And our own here, what I want to say from this angle, because when you want to kill a tree, if you cut it from the head, you have not killed the tree. One of the best way to kill the tree is to go to the taproot, cut it from the taproot. The tree will eventually die. It can't be like say we know they handle security matter from the top root. We they handle it from the top. That's why I said initially, security matter not be something to be politicized. You don't trivialize it. You don't put it under the carpet. You don't use black paint to paint something that is white. That is why I like the way he put it, that we are here to really discuss security matter. And in my own area, I believe that if we are going to handle security matter, make we go to the grassroots. Make we see the root cause of this security matter. If we are talking more on the grassroots, I believe we'll be making success.
Okay, okay, yes, but Sharish, like this brother and like the challenge they face now, say, if, for instance, he goes somewhere, they say thief, they come, they help catch thief. At the end of the day, they come say they don't see God for help. Where you to see they go start from? So that, because you know, two things when we say they get now, number one, I first tell them just and say, two things every year. The areas, the communities, in a way, supposed to engage them. So, okay, I beg you, Mukuna come, but like I talk, some areas where I don't see. They say, Mukuna come, now, go to help us to do something. You know. Come, go meet the DP of so area. Come, go meet Commissioner of Police of that area. Oga, now these people, now they help us for here, in case of anything, you know, see their face, see their everything. Uh-huh, then those ones go know them. But, when they see, say, that relationship not there. But notwithstanding, the other men for the other time, say, Mukuna. Forget us, this man. And then they follow us, they go inside bush. All the time. When we get to do kind of thing. I say, okay, like, who they will kidnap that time? You get one very notorious kidnap, what they do for this. In fact, even guess who say they come from, whether some Bayelsa women or something. Let's say they come from somewhere in Lagos, yes, they come kidnap. You understand? They get some of their men, that they help them go inside. So, what do you try to talk say? To you, what do you go advise them?
Advise them.
Yeah, all these people.
I've just said it. How we are, because security matter is very delicate, not a small matter. Mm. Anybody who put a leg for security matter, it's a very dangerous matter. And for you to do security matter, my security issue without being harmed, that is a different ball game. But when you want to begin to say you want to catch armed robbers that are having guns and you don't get guns, you know how to play your game. And the best game you need to play is to have a good relationship with police. Because you are also assisting them to do their work. The security work, everybody work. But in a way, you're also assisting them. And as you're assisting them, there's a way you marry them. When you marry them, they can defend you at any time.
Bright, how Nate they relate with security agencies?
No, right from beginning, our major aim is to support the law enforcement agent. That is how we have been doing it. But recently, we started partnering with them. Like these
are not
the
partner with them before.
No, because the way one before said before, if you bring everything, that you will still write statement. So most of us can rebel against that. Say we are trying to help. Then in the end, we will write statement. So, but now, they don't even give our boys their ID card from the headquarters. But what we are saying, we are still doing voluntary service.
No, apart from the voluntary, before we reach the issue of voluntary service, like I talk, it depends on the community. I know so many communities where they try to engage private security to protect their area. Mm-hmm. So, who like, you know, the kind of home saying you choose.
Yes.
But as a body, you know, if you say, I'm supposed to do work with the commissioner of police, the DPOs, you understand? Because like you talked just now, area where you did and DPO know you, you're not supposed to get problem.
You are correct. You see, first of all, even there was a time when I came here, I said, the time when this IG first day, they work with OPC. They work well with OPC. What we are trying to say is we want a situation where they should open the door. At times, when we write later, say we won't see, they won't come pay courtesy visit to the DPO as a way of familiarizing ourselves with them. Most of them, they are not willing to absorb us, to listen to us.
Oh, the DPOs?
The DPOs, yes. Because we've directed our members in all the local government that they should pay courtesy visit to the DPOs so that you familiarize yourself with them.
Judicial.
But they don't accommodate us. No. When you want to go greet person, you reject, they say no deal. You understand? What we are straight, what for now?
No, but the way they're supposed to do that kind of thing, because why would he talk him? We are already here. Problem, they grant. You understand? Because I remember, you know what they thought this is? I think this commissioner of police now?
Sure.
Rain and the one before this one.
Mm.
Somebody, they do renunciation of court. Court members. The commissioner of police, look. He quickly just signed the paper. Look, go and meet my OC anti-courtesy. That we should work together. Meet them work together. I said, why? Because they did help him. If somebody, for instance, you collect two guns from two people in the place, you don't have police. You don't have security agents. Because those guns, not go work, not go do evil. I mean, also, if not from where say people won't surrender, like there may be four or five guns. You understand? So, the issue is that I believe so now, see, get one role to play to hit the top. Any CP welcome, now if I go meet and say, see, we'll be in our brothers, we'll be in our servant. Just in case, anytime, we'll do what they do on ground. Now, don't reach out to this. Okay, now, we'll start. This current CP, now, don't feel reach out to them.
No, nobody say we don't want it. You see, once beaten, twice shy. We don't want the situation to come like saying our pest will be to them. You understand what I'm trying to
do? No, okay. May you comment on that?
I think you see, I was with the commissioner of police a few days ago.
Okay.
I went there, the door was open.
Before you talk, first we see the Wakari Ghost once more on the program Dota, the reach from Independent Television, Edo State, Nigeria. Now, issue of security will be everybody on. Not be really if you were to watch your area, not be this one now, like we see. I just give you an example just now. Every one of us will get a role to play. Not be to the police. When you see the kind of police vehicle, when your police with the area they use, you will not say even you get a role to play. You talk about the doors of the commercial police.
Yes, like what I was saying just now. I think the door of the commissioner of police is open for everybody, especially when it comes to the issue of security.
Yes, because they help.
I was with him a few days ago.
Mm-hmm.
I talked one-on-one with him.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very easygoing man
mm-hmm.
who want to see the security of Edo State.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that if this, your group, there's a way you package yourself and go there and introduce yourself and pay a kind of a courtesy visit. And telling who you are, I believe what you will get from there.
And what you have done before.
And what you are, your antecedents,
mm-hmm.
your works, you make them, make him to understand your grant in Edo State. I believe the man is very understanding. He will give you all the necessary backing. He will give you all the necessary backing. And with that one, even my DPO here, Nubawa, I took some people to his office. I told him, sir, tell people I want to see you. He said, my door is open. So I connected them, they went to see him on security matter. He was very happy and he encouraged them that he will give them every necessary support anytime they call him.
What about the government of Nigeria? What do you say they feel do?
On the area of
Government of Nigeria, because these people now, in a way, we don't see any help. They need to be encouraged. So how what do you feel then how government of Nigeria, what do you feel the government of Nigeria to feel to encourage them to?
I think that is security is government responsibility.
Yes.
I think the government of the day is very, very important. They look at what they are doing. For saving lives alone is something. In any way, they can come up with a package to encourage them, because somebody cannot be in the bush risking his life, and at the end of the day, there's nowhere to fall back to financially. They should be encouraged financially. The government should do something about it to encourage them so they can do more to assist the police, to keep the police safe.
Right, your brother said me you see also reach a courtesy visit to the commissioner of police.
Nobody say we did wrong. We have done it before. Mm. Nobody say we did wrong.
But you know, sir, you're supposed to continue to do it because commissioner of police not spend like 2 years for police. So if you the highest commissioner would not spend like almost 2 years and 9 months or be 8 months, maybe for lunch.
Mm.
The other ones 8 months, 6 months, 3 months, 4 months. 5 months, so you go continue to the rapport because now different commission, I would say.
And nobody say we know, say no. Waiting me, they try talk.
Mm.
Right from beginning, the old Oduwa People's Congress, OPC, is known for supporting the law enforcement agents. To me, that is not the cross of the matter now. The insecurity in Edo State, the best solution now, make every community, all youth in different communities, let them secure their community. Because these people are coming in hundreds. At times, you see trailers, you go shock. And Edo State, they've gotten the signal that it's a safe haven for some. They run from other states, now here they can't stay. Our youth should wake up. Let's face reality. That is why when they talk, this one you talk about, before police come, we have traditional security guiding the kings in those days. Mm. Are you listening to me? Mm. So the pattern is still there.
Make them do their own Amoteku.
God bless you. So the Amoteku is a signal. The South-South, we from Edo to this thing, the system. Let's do it on time before the killings becoming too much. Our people now, they are not sleeping with their two eyes.
Mostly from the village.
But first of all, that's what I'm saying. That's why the youth will wake up. Let us come together. Because how can you, for somebody, a different person, to come and drive you from your ancestral home? Then do you know the government is now saying, make people go farm. Now, as I'm telling you, to go farm in Edo, you are not sure of coming back. Because if they contract your enemy there, you know what happens. The earlier, the better. The definition of security, as we have our own traditional security, right from before police. So you both can't bring police.
May you see, take our governors too now. You don't need to take governors.
Call the youth. Let us, OPC is a spiritual congress. As I said it before, let's put heads together. Make una no come here. Simple, go. And if you do evil, like go to Lagos and what happened? They catch instantly jungle justice.
But we're not going to encourage young
people. I know we know you encourage them. What I'm saying is violence begat violence.
No, but we're not going to encourage them because now the law of the land, I would say they follow.
But you know, things saying that this subtlety when they talk now, now make people they come and do come and they kill our great heroes for here, they destroy them, they kidnap them, they collect millions from us. Make we put our hand. If you saw what happened in the Southwest now, when the youth came up, they said they want to fight Boko Haram themselves. Are you listening to me? This is the high time for us. Let's tell the people the truth. With this, the insecurity in Edo, my dear, anyway, maybe when it don't happen to one big man, then everybody will not react. This is the time for us to wake up.
Sheriff.
The security matter really is becoming, it's increasing every day. Like what I said, if we can address it from the grassroots, I think we can make an headway. And how do we address it from the grassroots? Let us begin to sensitize ourselves. Sensitization is very, very important.
Not be one of the ones they do now.
Look at coronavirus.
Before we talk, we'll come on here, time not day again, but at least we'll see some time. Any part of the world where they watch us from, if you just call our phone number 052-290-573 or 080-3500-796. I talk them again. 052-290-573. Or 080-3500-793. We will just get one or two comments from you over what we will talk since, where we just say we will strengthen our security apparatus, at least for now, so that most of this private security to go feed the do job body with the government. But I think, Bright, one of the things we will kind of come off here is say, on your own, may you and your people more than work more with security agencies. Then, two, the area of engagement, yes, I think that doesn't get to do government, but at least now they do good work because other people when they do and for they testify. When people for street sleep with two eyes closed, maybe like the street people say, you know, they do again now. Tomorrow they know if we call it. I mean, so but when
even
people
this
they street,
morning, they see they rock for
when people street for the people for street, they sleep with two eyes closed, they know that's a Christian place. They pay put for other country, like somebody coming last or other country, now everything they pay for. Abi, if you want security, you know, pay. The people now, we just talk on one side. All this special protection, where did they give all the other people, all these VIP, where did they give all these senators and all? Then they pay. You don't know. Then they pay. If you watch all those police, they give all the big men, it's not free.
No.
Not say they just give them free. No. As you just see police, they just, nah, it's not free. So, other countries, for light, for water, for security, for everything, they pay. So maybe we know they look at one side, say, okay, private security, they're your area, or they do this or they want. When they say, maybe bring money for security, say you don't go pay. which get that when we would advocate say make federal government increase money of police, then the one who say they do private security, you the sleep person, the guy you say you no go pay, you no go, you no work like that. No tell this call. Hello, good evening. Hello. Good evening, no. Hello. From Udo Jobo.
Udo Jobo.
Okay, okay, go ahead. Yes. Yes. What's on? Yes.
I see many things will happen.
Yes.
My brother. Now only we use the eyes here. I will be described by it.
So what do you think we'll feel do now? Okay. We don't talk about a problem since you know we talk since. What do you think we can do now? Now the solution will be the look for now, all of us.
Yes. The solution
Will
be part of us, just as this OPC man is talking about.
Yes.
The very important thing is that make all the youth, make them come out. Make them come out, make police empower us, make them join us, make them give us that opportunity to take help the communities. So that all this insecurity of a thing, it will be a thing of the past. Like your guest earlier said, he said, if it don't happen to one big man,
we're not going to wait for that one. We're not going to wait for that one. It's me. I put the one big man first. Because all of us are equal before the hand of God. That big man, we just put African mentality. Okay, bless another person. See, they call. Let me take like two or three calls for inside the program. We'll call come out. Hello? Thank you very much. Hello? Okay, yes. So,
like I was saying, we have to address it from the top. Let us sensitize the people on security matter. Let's enlighten ourselves. Let's educate ourselves. They won't begin to educate ourselves because
we don't do the education now. After the education, what step should we take?
Then we begin to take action.
No, excuse me. Let me say something. This one, when Pastor Sharif talks, let's educate the people. Let's say we have passed that stage. For now, everybody has to be on alert because the atrocities these people are committing now is increasing every day.
Yes.
It's increasing every day. So it's not the time now for us to...
People don't feed the chop.
Let the youth come out.
People don't feed chop.
Yes,
why? Because no food.
Yeah, and the thing is not enough
go far.
For only the policemen, the law enforcement...
Hello? Hello? Hello, good evening. Hello? What? That call,
not confirmed. As I talk, nobody don't even work, they live for only
law
enforcement agent.
Hello?
Good evening, though. What's your name? Where they call us from? Hello?
Hello, good evening.
Yes, good evening. What's your name? Where they call us from?
Yeah, my name is Osagie Akele.
Okay.
Hello, Osagie Akele.
Will they hear you, sir? Will they hear you? Will they hear you? Go ahead.
The real aspect of it, sorry, let me use the pigeon.
Yes.
So, the thing will really matter for this justice. The real aspect of this matter, you see, those security we want to bring out from those youths, as we are saying it now, are they going to handle us?
They don't need to handle arm, not the issue of arm now. At least let us see that we are working together as a people.
Yes.
First of all, because a couple like say we two will not even just join. You understand? Not the issue of arm now. We know we come like say we'll never join.
What I'm saying is that all those people we are talking about now. All those people we are talking about now. They are ready with arms to pursue. Okay, those who are pursuing them in the farm now, and the bush everywhere now. Is it ordinary thing? Is it ordinary hand? We have to call the government for this matter.
Okay, now I make you the talk so now. You are calling
properly and give them the equipment.
Okay. I think that's the only call we take now because time not again. At least now the matter now make all of us there, make everybody see what is going for inside our community. Yes, so hello my brother Adebole. Time not again, just one word of advice.
To me, like what my God talked before, every community get youth. Now me know how my house be. Now you know how your house be. Me when they, for instance, I did Uselu. I don't know if I can tell you the story of Oyogi. Now you went to Oyogi, and the people went to Oyogi. Now you know the bush and the road when Oyogi did. So if they feed one like that, like I talked about just now, I say no community when UPC no day. If the youth of that community agree to work with our people, what did they define for which community they will get down?
Okay, just a minute. Time now, they never reach me. Few seconds. Just your wrap up.
Nobody is born to be a criminal. God did not create anyone to be a criminal. So if you have a criminal mind, it's not the will of God. It will be very bad that you leave this world and they said before you left, you made people to cry. It's a very bad record. You can impact your life. You can change from all these wicked ways. If you know you are that type of still carry gun looking for people's life, it is high time for you to drop that gun. Because that carry gun.
Well, more of the time, not again. They don't.
Our people, we don't talk waiting. We won't believe, say, we'll check in security. We beg all the youth, wake up now.
All right, time not again for this program. Again, by next week, we'll come again. This setup we will see come here. We will reassess what we do on the way forward for this issue of insecurity. Until then, good night and God bless Nigeria. Bye-bye.